Hey everyone, it's Alex from Engineering Applied. Welcome to the part creation module for Autodesk Inventor. This introductory video contains a broad overview of the available functions found when opening a new part file for the first time. For a more detailed look at specific functions, check out my other videos within the part creation module. I went ahead and broke the series down into easily digestible segments to deliver the most relevant content for your convenience. For quick reference to a specific function, check the description for timestamps. If you want to stay up to date on future tutorials like this one, or fun engineering projects and other cool stuff, make sure you subscribe and turn on channel notifications. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. So currently we're on the home screen. So what we're going to do first is we're going to launch a part file. So when we click part, it takes us to our new part design window. And there's several different areas within the ribbon that are separated into different sections. And I'll do a broad overview of what these offer and what you would typically use these for. And I'll go into further detail in future videos. So stick around for those. So moving along the top here, we have our selection filter dropdown. So this is really nice when we're actually diving into the model and we only want to select certain features. So say, for example, I only want to pick up sketch features, I would go down to select sketch features. If I wanted to pick up both faces and edges, which is what I typically keep it on unless the part gets extremely complex, or if for whatever reason, I only want to select certain things in there. So we're going to leave it on select face and edges, and we're going to continue on along the top. This next bubble here is the material selection. So when you click material, it'll take you to a selection menu. So say, for example, we're working with aluminum 6061, which is a pretty common thing in the aerospace industry for you aerospace guys out there, especially in the product design field, which I have personal experience in. But yeah, you could scroll through here and look at all the available materials. There's tons in here. They have their unique characteristics, their color characteristics and textures and stuff. It's really cool. I encourage you to play around with that a little bit. Moving over, we have another dropdown. So this dropdown also gives us access to our material libraries. So this is more of a quick access means to an end here. So say, for example, if I use nylon 66 or PA66 is sometimes what you'll see it as, then you have it here available to you and you can select that as needed. Moving over, we have the appearance menu. So like the material menu, the appearance menu allows you to do what this says and select your appearance. So there's tons of different textures, colors, all sorts of good stuff in here to really bring some life to your models. And this is really important when you start to do realistic renderings of your models. You want it to look as, well, realistic as possible. So this is where you would start. Moving along, we have our quick access menu for the colors and textures and whatnot. Here we can adjust the colors that we may have assigned to a part. Here we can clear those settings that we have assigned to a part. We have our parameter editing menu. So we open this up and so say for example, I have a set of standard parts. So say I'm designing a new set of washers. I can set, let's say, the interior hole diameter to a certain variable D0, let's say. Well, I can come in here and modify parameters quickly in one place to suit the design need. So this is a really handy menu, and we'll get more into detail on this in the future. Okay, so moving across the top here, there's nothing new that we haven't seen. If you have any questions about any of the toolbars and the generic stuff that's available to you, I have another video that I'll link here. So you can go back and watch that and get a little bit more detail on that. Okay, so within the 3D model tab, this is where we're really going to start. This is the foundation in which we're going to build our knowledge on part design within Autodesk Inventor. So this first area here is our sketch tab. So the sketch tab is obviously where you start creating your sketches. You have available to you 2D sketches and 3D sketches. I'll go into depth about those in a different video. Okay, so the next section is create. So what the create section allows us to do is it allows us to add some 3D geometry to our model or take away from that 3D geometry or solid body. So pretty standard tools here. We'll go more into depth on these in a different video. Moving over, we have Modify. What Modify is it allows us some tools to, well, do what it says, create some modifications to the model. So that's adding fillets, holes, and a bunch of other standard features that are typically available in most CAD software packages. Explore. The shape generator is one of my favorite tools in Autodesk Inventor. And essentially what this does is it allows you to create some loading conditions on your part. And what it does is it'll tell you the areas of the solid that's not necessary to withstand those loads to whatever factor of safety that you set in this part. It's a hugely valuable tool, especially if you're in the automotive or aerospace industry where your parts have to be as light as possible, but without compromising your structural integrity. So I highly encourage all of you to check out this tool and use it. Of course, you want to validate your data with hand calculations and, you know, things of the like, but anyhow, it's a great tool and I encourage you to use it. The next section is work features. What work features is it allows you to put some reference geometry into your model. So you'll notice in future tutorials, I'll use a lot of extra planes or points or an extra axis to help define certain geometry that I'm either adding or taking away from my model. Okay, so the next section is pattern. And the tools available in pattern allow you to automate some of the processes when you're designing. So say for example, I have a square plate and I want a rectangular hole pattern of four holes in the plate itself. So instead of me going and modeling four separate circles on the top surface of the plate and then cutting all four of those separately, we want to use good design intent here and help automate this process. So say in the future, I want to change the spacing of the hole pattern or maybe change the size of the holes. I only have to make one change and it automates that for us and it blows those changes through for us. So really useful stuff in here. Create freeform. So this allows us to take a standard shape such as like a box that you see here or several other of these standard shapes and then sort of mold the surface into a custom profile. So this is really nice for more eccentric design profiles. Think computer mouse, right? It has to ergonomically fit in your hand or maybe a power drill or something like that. So you can play around with the geometry in a more complex manner using some of these standard features here. Surface. Again, surfacing allows you to create some really complex geometry. Again, think about a computer mouse or in the automotive industry, you're talking about the styling and the curves associated with a car design. So you'll see those standard surface tools in this section. Measure. It's just a tool that allows us to measure the geometry within our model. Think a virtual caliper or ruler that you can use to double check dimensions and things like that. I use this all the time. You're probably going to use it all the time. It's a great tool to have. Here, we can perform a stress analysis and run our part through a simulation based on various loading conditions and constraints that we assign. Next is we have convert. Convert allows us to convert this part design file into a sheet metal part. So if we click that, it gives us our sheet metal design options. And if we click that by mistake, for example, we just go back to 3D model and convert that back to a standard part. Next, we have a dropdown here that allows us to add or take away sections from our ribbon. So let's say, for example, I want to model up a wire harness for my assembly or for my part. I can click harness and right there, it adds the options for creating a harness. Moving over to this corner, we have our view cube. So essentially what the view cube does is it allows us to modify or move around the view of our part. So for this example, I'm going to go ahead and model up a cube. So I'm just going to create a sketch here. And we'll make it about 0.5 by 0.5. And we'll go ahead and extrude this. Okay. So we've got our cube here. And when I'm looking at this, I can actually click on a feature or face in this view cube, and I can rotate it a little bit. So there, it'll sort of snap to views along that angle. I can also click the home button to go back to that original isometric view. So say, for example, I'm looking at the front view of my part, I can click home and it'll take me back to that corner. I can also click on the corners themselves and look at an isometric view of specific corners. If I want to rotate the part around the axis normal to the face that I'm looking at, I can look at a face specifically, and then I can just click these little left and right arrows and it'll rotate it around that axis. Moving down here, we have our navigation menu. So if I click that, I can do a bunch of different things here. So if we don't want to use our keyboard or mouse shortcuts to rotate the part or to zoom on the part or whatever, I can also use this. So if I click and hold here, I can orbit. I can pan the part around and you know, all of that good stuff. Here is our pan option. So this just pans the part around the screen. Zoom, orbit. So we saw orbit. And we have our look at feature. So look at essentially provides us with a view normal to the face that we select. So if I want to look normal to that face, that's how we do it. Moving over here, we have our design tree or our model tree, and we can open up specific features, look at sketches, rename various features and such. So you have access to all of your geometry and all of your features right here in one place. We can search for specific features. So if I wanna find that sketch one, I can type in sketch one, hit enter, and it'll find it for me. So when you have a really big catalog or a lot of features in your part, this is a very nice way to hone in on features that you're looking for. We have some different options in here for expansion of the different features, so we can expand everything all in one shot. We can collapse it in one shot. You know, we have our display preferences and such in there. And so that's everything in the 3D toolbar and in the navigation space. If you click on these other tabs, we can have some specific options for sketch, annotations, inspecting your part. This is really handy for double checking features on your part before you get into a 2D drawing, your various tools for also checking the part in various ways, changing the appearance and such. We have manage here, so we can look at our parameters and go through all these different options here. We have our view options in this ribbon. Environments, this is where you would access your simulation under stress analysis, or we can create a render view in Inventor Studio, or we can convert this or export this part as an STL for our 3D printing. Get started, it just has some of the basic options that we've reviewed previously in other videos. So you can open new files, open existing files, look at projects, so on and so forth. Okay, so the final tab is collaborate. And under collaborate, we have the option to share views of our model with, so this could be sharing our views with customers, vendors, or other team members. And we also have our web section. So in the web section, it allows us access to supplier standard content. So this would be off the shelf hardware and things of that nature. And we also have our inventor ideas. So this allows us to send Autodesk our ideas of how we think we could improve the software. So if you have a good idea on how to improve the software or maybe the user interface or something like that, feel free to click on that link and let them know. That concludes this overview of the Autodesk Inventor part creation module. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and turn on notifications to stay up to date on future content as it's released. And as always, don't hesitate to reach out and let me know if there's anything else you'd like to learn about or see on this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.